Hello everyone. I'm going to be working on this Linocut to make a stamp. I made my design in here in pencil, if you can see. This is a very inexpensive material and very hard, but at the same time flexible. I know it's harder than the pink other material that I worked in another video, but at this point the most important decision we have to make is what you dig out and carve out of your design and what parts you leave standing in a relief. So those are the parts that will get the ink or the acrylic paint that you're going to apply to stamp on your paper and your artwork. What I'm going to do is I'm going to leave this little seed pod with part outside be untouched, and the part on pencil I'm going to be carving out. It could be the opposite, it could be whatever you want. You see whatever your design calls and you just follow. If I wanted to make the seed carved out and leave the inside sticking out, then I would most likely, just to tell myself and a reminder, I would paint them with my pencil, all of those parts that will go out to be carved. But in this particular case, I just want to have the shapes and leave as an outline, sort of. So it's going to look pretty much as you see here. For a reminder for myself, I color in black, either with a Sharpie or with a pencil, whatever I have handy, the parts that I want to be erased, or it could be the opposite. Not erased, but you know what I mean. Carved out. It'll be really easy if you can erase them. But make a drawing in a way that you know what parts you want out and what parts you want carved. So the parts that are in a relief sticking out, those are the ones that are going to get the ink. Don't forget that. It's the only tricky part. Excuse my voice. I'm kind of getting better of a cold. But I'm going to be speeding the process, and you will get to see what I do. I'm going to be using the speedball tool, which has a bunch of little, of course it wasn't, this wasn't the right side, okay? Leave this side alone, oh my gosh. Hold on. Here's the other half. Anyway, now that I discombobulated the front, I'm going to show you what I wanted to show you, which is this is the back part where you keep the little blades. So I'm going to be using this super skinny one. And since I want just the lines, I will use the skinny one all over, except for this part where the other, maybe this one, is going to be useful to get more of the material out faster. And so now, will you please excuse me? I'm going to put this thing back together again the right way. I will be back. I can tell you right now, this is a lot harder than the pink one. I'm going to take a little break for my finger and then I will continue. Now I'm going to dig out the little circles inside of the seeds and then all this part. I'm going to change blades for this second part. I want to do the spaces in between, and hopefully I can use this bigger one Anyway, I'm going to try with this and see what happens. Well, I can see it is way too big for the details that I have here. So I'm just going to go in the spots that I can and go back with another one. Maybe this one. There is a very sharp triangle looking thingy. But I think I'm going to go with this one. In a few minutes anyway. And you know how you left your lines in here? Those are the stop lines also. So that the blade kind of stops there. Otherwise, you just go phew, like I did here from one side to the other, but it is a very light scratch. But hopefully you can see enough of this that you get the point of this video. Okay, I finished this part with this other bigger blade, and I can tell you it was super difficult. You have to keep going against the material and far away from you. Do not put your fingers like this because you're going to end up with a nasty scratch. And it is really hard, much harder of course than the pink one. This Lino material is tough, and maybe they have another kind of blade that is stronger or sharper than this. Most likely they do, but so far it's okay. If you can only have this kind, it's okay, but definitely a sharper blade would be more helpful. So now I'm going to be carving the little holes inside. And later on, changing of blade, I'm going to be using something for getting rid of the outside, and I'll go back to speeding the process. I might leave it like this. I'm kind of liking the circle in the middle. I'm going to leave it for now and see how it works with the ink and all, and then make some changes if needed. And since I'm sitting far away from the camera, I don't know if you heard me, but I'm going to leave the little holes, okay? The little Cheerio shapes. Okay, the way I'm doing it is I am pressing the material and turning with my other hand. I'm not moving this blade, but still we have to always be careful because this is sharp. I'm going to be leaving these little lines over here to give it more movement, or at least that's my intention. If I don't like them, I can just come back and shave them off. But for now, I want to leave these little grooves in here. And now I switched to another blade. And this is a little wider. And I'm going to be working on getting rid of these other parts over here. I can tell you this rounder, larger blade is less control for my hand. It's just going wherever it wants and fast. I cannot keep it down like the sharp V. And it's kind of scary, especially with something so hard. I'm thinking I'm going to just clip this off because, after all, if I have something too long far away from my design, it's going to be flapping, especially because I'm planning to use it as stamp like this and not necessarily pressing the art on top of the stamp. That is an option, but it's not always what I do. So I'm going to clip them with a big pair of scissors or an X-Acto knife and save me some time of just going through this thing, okay? Okay, I trimmed the edges and I kind of went a little bit around it to make them even more towards the back. And I'm going to test it now with some acrylic paint. So I will know what parts I have to still fix. Ooh, I like it. The acrylic is not exactly the best thing to use for a stamp because it can go everywhere, unlike the ink. But I like painting with acrylic. And I even like this one that is very sloppy. I like it. And this one looks awesome. All of them, actually. I'm going to wait for this to dry. This is just a little journal for testing stuff. I will try it now, and this Bristol paper. Well, I thought I had left enough of a thick line over here, but if you see, the line is so skinny, it just doesn't make the difference between ink, space, and ink. It just goes all over the place, or actually paint, not ink. In here you can see it a little better, right there. I was thinking that it was going to show more like this line that is quite separate. Let's see if this ghost print is going to show anything that I might like. Yeah, even this way, in person, it looks nice. I don't know how it looks in the video, but I like it. I hope you enjoyed this video. And if this is the first time that you're visiting, click on the little button over here to subscribe and select in the menu the option to get my notifications every time I upload a video, which is Tuesdays. Thanks for stopping by. And remember to keep your paintbrush wet. Talk to you later. Bye. This is another way of applying the ink. I just went and put it on top of the roll paint over here and the pad, and put the stamp on top, so it's completely uneven and it looks really, really good. I like it. Anyway, this was just a little extra thing. It can be used also for card making and just about anywhere you can print.